الله يا الله يا
يا ربي يا ربي يا ربي يا يا الله يا
Okay, we're about to get started. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Good evening.
My name is Samuel Guy, and I'm going to kick off today's activity. Dr. Khan will take us through the entire program once I give some initial remarks.
Can you please call him Professor Khan? It gets confusing for me.
Okay,
that's true.
I take it you're an MD. Okay, Professor Khan. We have many important guests here. You each have a program. We're expecting President Bullock and Councilman Holland. They have several places they have to go this evening, but they had hoped to stop by.
Ted Rose is here. Councilman Holland is walking up.
Okay, and we're going to have County Executive Gordon, who's going to also be one of the speakers today. And we have Mr. Tork, Mr. Khan, Rabbi Beals, Imam Umar Hassanel, Reverend Greg Jones, and Professor Khan. We'll wrap it up at the end. So, as you know, today is a proclamation signing. And the topic is the Eid holiday. And what we're here today to do as a community is to encourage everybody to recognize the Eid holiday, because there's a lot of people in the Newcastle County community that aren't familiar with the Eid holiday.
The Eid holiday.
Eid holiday. Okay. The Eid holiday. And so we want to first thank you for coming. And we have a common purpose, and that is bringing the community together in the name of religious freedom. Because here in Delaware, this is a state that's known for the history of religious freedom. And so everybody should have the right to practice their religion freely and openly, and no one should be treated inappropriately because of their religion. And so the young folks in particular, we're glad that you're here, because we want you to have a great quality of life as you live here in Newcastle County. And we want you to be treated fairly, just like every other kid who gets to practice their religion and to be proud and participate when they have holidays as well. So thank you, young folks, for being here, as well as the adults. So without any further ado, I'm going to turn the program over to Professor Khan, who's the Associate Professor of Islam and Global Affairs in the Department of Political Science and International Relations at the University of Delaware, and he's also the heart of the Delaware Council on Global and Muslim Affairs. Dr. Khan.
Assalamu alaikum to everybody, and good evening for all of you for coming here. And just so that Jamil doesn't get upset, he's the heartbeat of the Delaware Council. One of our very esteemed speakers, and who is like an elder brother to me in faith, has to rush. So I, without much ado, I invite Reverend Greg Jones to come and speak to us. He's a very important and busy man, wanted in many cities.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm very supportive of this proclamation to recognize Muslim holidays. People of faith and people of no faith are well acquainted with Christmas and Easter. And you can imagine what would happen if suddenly people were told they could not recognize those holidays, that Christians would holler religious persecution. while we could do a better job of recognizing Yom Kippur, Rosh Hashanah, Passover, there are many businesses and schools that recognize some of these important days on the Jewish calendar. In my mind, what we're talking about today is an issue of fairness and awareness. Not only will this proclamation on Eid encourage schools to accommodate their students and businesses to accommodate their employees, but it will help all people, Christians, Jews, and people of no faith at all, to better understand the values of Islam. Not the values of terrorists who try to hijack the hijack Islam with their extremist positions, not genuine Islamic positions. So this will help us better understand what's at the core of Islam: giving to people in need, the virtue of honesty, loving your neighbor. These important values that these three faiths we're talking about today all have in common. Many politicians fan the flames of Islamophobia. I'm grateful that Delaware's leaders recognize the importance of respecting every faith that promotes love of neighbor. Members of my own congregation, Westminster Presbyterian in Wilmington, have had a number of activities and discussions and conversations with both Jewish groups and Islamic groups, Muslims. And in these discussions, they come out very excited. Our people are so excited to build these friendships and to see how much our faiths have in common with one another. It's vital to the future of our state, our nation, and our world that we better understand one another and that we better respect one another. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Reverend Johnson. He has been very consistent defending the Muslim community. I have spoken many times over the years in his church. There is proof of the fact that he's been open to listening about Islam and from Muslims. And his wonderful wife, Camille, was also with us here. Thank you very much to both of you. Our next speaker is the Honorable Penrose Hollins, who's going to speak on the importance of this recognition. He's President Pro Tempore of Newcastle County.
Thank you very much. I am honored to join Deputy CEO Sam Guy, as well as the County Executive Tom Gordon, and all of you to be here today to pay respect to the Islamic holidays. And unlike Donald Trump, we will not be building walls in Newcastle County. We will build bridges to bring our communities together. In Newcastle County, we recognize that our diversity is the centerpiece of the progress of this county government. And every community in Newcastle County is a critical component of that fabric, which makes us uniquely Newcastle County. And every citizen in Newcastle County has a right to share in our progress. We do not see us and them, it is we, the people. When we look at others, we see ourselves in others, and we recognize that we have far more in common than we have differences. So I enjoy the idea that you decided to let us be a part to show you how much we really value your holidays, how much we respect your holidays, and I agree with Reverend Jones that it's about time that we recognize that everyone in Newcastle County is equal. Everyone here has the right to religion, and we respect that religion. May God bless you, and thank you for coming with us today.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Honorable Hollins, for your important comments. Before I introduce the next speaker, who is the most important speaker today, I want to remind you about one of our former presidents, Teddy Roosevelt, who was also a police officer before he became president. But what was interesting was that the Muslims of New York did not ever refer to Teddy Roosevelt as President Roosevelt or Police Chief Roosevelt. They always referred to him as Khalif Harun Rashid. And the reason for that was because Teddy Roosevelt used to go out in the night into the neighborhoods of the immigrants of New York, and he used to go and check as to how the immigrants in those communities were doing. He wanted to know whether the newcomers to the city of New York were safe in his city when he was chief of police. So every time I meet with Tom, I remember this analogy of Harun al-Rashid. And Tom has, over the years, been very friendly to the American Muslim community in Delaware. He has visited our masajid. He probably knows every mosque in the county. He has spoken at many of our events. He has even spoken in my class very recently about outreach to Muslim communities. And what he's doing now for the Muslim community is perhaps really something that is an example for the rest of the country. I think all the politicians in America who are talking about integrating and assimilating Muslims and making Muslims feel at home, they have to learn from Tom Gordon. Nothing makes us feel at home as much as embracing not just us, but also our faith. So today, Tom Gordon is going to recognize our Eid, and in doing that, I hope he makes all Muslims who live in Delaware feel more Delawarean today.
Right.
Tom.
Before I start, let me recognize our Chief Administrative Officer, Tim Mullaney, is on the back steps here. He's very much wanted to be here today. Before I read this proclamation, which I am extremely honored to be able to do today, that I want to say that I'm glad that all the different religious communities came today to support this, and we have my rabbi here with me today. But I think Reverend Jones said it all. It's a shame what's going on in this country with some of the rhetoric, and we're here to say that we've had a bad relationship for over 3 years with our Muslim community. I've made so many friends, and I'm just very proud. It's sad that we even have to hear some of the rhetoric that's going on with the presidential race. Somebody said we're going to patrol Muslim communities, and here's the deal. All of our communities are Muslim communities. You might find them as your doctor, your neighbor, your civic association, but they're your friend. And we've got to fight against just, it only lasts till November and then it ends. But somebody found that it was a good thing to pick on one religion or another. Islam is the second largest religion in the country, in the world, soon going to be number one. They're peaceful, they're loving, and I got to know so many of them. Now, my hardest problem is going to be speaking in Arabic. So, from my proclamation, which I want to read, because I am just deeply honored to be able to do this today, because it is so unfair that every religion is recognized but a Muslim religion. But a child might not be able to take the day off in a very important ceremonious, very sacred day. And to be able to do this is so small that what I say to all your children is Newcastle County, the police department, the paramedics, all your friends, it's your government. And you're welcome anytime. Come by my office and have a cup of coffee. And again, I want to salute all the religious leaders that made this so valuable to show that everybody is standing up and saying, we have our holidays, why shouldn't you have your holidays? So let me start with a proclamation that I'm probably most proud of doing in my 12 years as executive. From the office of the County Executive of Newcastle County, be it hereby known to all, the Honorable Thomas B. Gordon, Newcastle County Executive, issues this proclamation to recognize Muslim holidays. Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. We're going to work on that. Whereas Islam is one of the world's major religions, part of our shared human heritage. And whereas the history of the people of the Muslim faith includes some of the greatest and most advances in innovation, society, and history of human existence. Whereas from the early days of the pioneers to our present day leaders, Muslims have played a significant role in the history of Newcastle County's economic, cultural, spiritual, and political. And whereas there are several thousand Muslims residing in Newcastle County, Delaware, contributing every day to the economy, the social fabric, the multicultural and pluralistic traditions of this state. Whereas the Muslims reside in Newcastle County and in the state of Delaware with their hard work and contributions to medicine, to science, to information society, technology, to education,
and so many other fields that we know, have benefited from enriched, and they have enriched an open, tolerant, and economically vibrant economy of our county. Whereas the Muslims annually celebrate two religious holidays, Eid al-Fitr and the holy month fasting of Ramadan, where I have got to attend outside of Ramadan, and I couldn't believe 7,000 people inside, that got my attention, that what a wonderful, beautiful, off script for a second, what a wonderful, peaceful religion. And Eid al-Adha, during the pilgrimage of Hajj. And whereas, in accordance with the sentiments of the United States President Barack Obama, Ramadan is a time to respect spiritually, build communally, and aid in those in need. While Eid al-Fitr marks the end of the Ramadan, it marks a new beginning for each individual, a reason to celebrate and to express the gratitude of this holiday. And whereas, during the two Eids, all people are encouraged to reflect on the past successes and challenges of the Muslims and to look forward to the future to continue to improve our society so that we live up to the ideas of freedom, equality, and justice. Whereas Newcastle County recognizes the celebration of both Muslim holidays henceforth as part of and parcel to the county's religious and to our cultural heritage. And whereas I extend the best regards to the Muslims in Newcastle County, Delaware, and throughout the world who celebrate Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. And whereas, as these holidays are celebrated, this community must remember the critical importance of the respect that this is to be accorded to all faiths and beliefs as reflected in the First Amendment of the United States Constitution that prohibits the making of any law respecting an establishment of religion and impeding the free and exercise of religion. Whereas Newcastle County Executive recommends that schools and employers in Newcastle County extend religious accommodation in accordance with existing laws to many Muslim students in our schools and Muslim workers throughout our county. And I would include the state of Delaware. Therefore, now I, Thomas P. Lord, Newcastle County Executive of Newcastle County, by virtue of the authority vested in me, I do hereby recognize Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha in Newcastle County, Delaware, and be it further resolved that I encourage all Newcastle County residents to join me in celebrating the collective ingenuity, creativity, culture, and traditions of the Muslims and commit ourselves to raise the awareness and appreciation of the two Adhas by participating in events honoring the contributions of Muslims. I call upon officials, educators, librarians, and all the people of Newcastle County to observe the two Eidas with appropriate programs, ceremonies, and activities. And I'm signing this today on the 19th day of April, 2016, by order of the County Executive Thomas B. Gordon, and I'm very proud to do it.
I'd like to thank Sam Guy for his work.
Oh, yeah.
This is truly a historical and emotional moment for all of us, and I cannot describe to you my feeling. I'm very proud, and I can I'm detained as commentator on BBC because I'm one of the few pro-American people. The people have accused me of being pro, but I never thought that I could become more pro-America as I am today. And I think I owe this to Tom. This country has always made us be, has recognized our individual self-worth, and it is such a proud moment that it has now recognized our collective worth. That is what has happened today. So I'm very grateful to Tom Gordon on behalf of the Delaware Council on Global and Muslim Affairs, on behalf of all the Muslims of Delaware and all the Muslims in America. I want to thank Tom Gordon for taking his brave step in this particular environment. If this was happening 4 years ago or 5 years ago, it would not have been that powerful. This is such a powerful moment. It is like saying that even in its worst moments, America shows its best. So this is at a moment when people like Donald Trump and Ted Cruz are proliferating Islamophobic statements. Tom Gordon steps forward and makes this powerful endorsement of American Muslims and Muslims of Delaware and the peacefulness of their faith. I'm also very happy to see that Naveed has joined us. The Delaware Council is a mosque with three minarets, and he's one of the most important of those three minarets. I want to now invite Jameel Turk, who is the chairman of the Delaware Council on Global and Muslim Affairs, if he can control his emotions, to come forward and share some of his thoughts and views with all of us.
First of all, I'd like to thank Tom.
Of course.
Tom could not have done it without Sam for this occasion. It's been 35 years in the making for me. I feel today not only emotional but proud because my country accepted me 25 years ago as an American, and today it accepted my faith. It makes me feel so proud that many of us here today are celebrating this. I know I was reminded today by Imam Salam that this started about 25 years ago when they went and rally the school districts, Red Plains School District, to really get this done. And today, we're taking another step for really fully recognize these holidays, because as Muslims, we have contributed a lot to this country, and this country is rewarding us today by saying thank you, and we are with you, and we will celebrate your holidays. And this would not have happened if the county, led by Tom Gordon and others, worked hard and were open-minded to the subject, especially in this kind of environment. But it also would not have happened if the interfaith community, led by Rabbi Beal, Greg Jones, and others, had said, we support this because we are equal. We are equal, all equal, under God. So we appreciate what you have done for us. We appreciate what you contribute to this country, and more than anything else, I thank you for completing my journey and becoming a full-fledged Muslim American. Thank you.
Didn't talk
to you. I thought you would get emotional and cry. The person who has influenced my life the most is undoubtedly Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. There are many aspects of his life that influenced me, but there's one thing that really left a huge impact on me when I read an episode in his life where I learned that every time when he was in a gathering or when he was in his house, whenever his daughter entered the room, he would stand up out of respect for his daughter Fatima. He would stand up, and that really left a huge impact on me. So it's a very special honor to me to invite my daughter, Ruhi Khan, to come here and address you about this moment. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum and good evening, everyone.
Assalamu alaikum.
A little too short. I'm here to express my profound gratitude and joy at the recognition of the Badis County. I represent the vast majority of students and youth who attend public schools. Eids are the celebrations that Muslims enjoy with their friends and family. Without community,
Eid cannot be celebrated. And we have brides, we have moon bounces and vendors that all come, and we have tons of activities. However, for many of the Eids, I have not been able to celebrate them with my family and friends as I would have liked to, mostly because of school. One of these particular Eids was my last one. On this day, I had a massive exam, and one that couldn't be missed. So I had to go to the earliest prayer at my mosque with my dad. He didn't even pray, he was just waiting in the car. And after I had finished praying, I had to quickly change my clothes and go to school in my uniform. And during this exam, while I'm taking this test, while I'm at school, I'm away from my family on the celebration day, where my family is out praying at a different time with all my friends whom I couldn't see that day. This is not an ideal Eid for me. Spending Eid away from my family and not praying with them and not praying with my family, that isn't the community that I like to cherish as a Muslim. Today is an important day for Muslims. I want to especially thank Tom Gordon and for the recognition for this holiday. It's really important for Muslims and it's important for me. Hopefully this will mean that I will not be having exams or too much homework on Eid, but hopefully this could lead to public holidays. This may be a small step for Islam, but it's a big step and a big blow against Islamophobia. Thank you.
I always feel that I have been robbed. I came to this country in the 1990s and I started studying Islamic thought, Islamic philosophy. So I became a professor of Islamic political philosophy before 9/11. But 9/11 just stole my life. I was forced to do things that I had no intention of doing, engaging in politics. I mean, I wanted to sit in my room, read, write, till I die. But now I have to talk. But so I entered the interfaith and I learned. I had no training or how to conduct myself. And one of the persons from whom I learned a lot about how to relate to people of other faiths and people of other communities is Rabbi Michael Beans. I've known him for many years. He's spoken in my class and we have interacted on many other, but the very demeanor, the empathy and the love with which he approaches the other is magnificent to behold. Rabbi.
Whenever we have a happy occasion in Judaism, we say mazal tov. So to the Islamic community, I say mazal tov. I want to say to you, salam alaikum. Shukran. So now we've experimented with Arabic. Let's teach you a little Hebrew, okay? So I think you put poor Commissioner Gordon on the ropes there with Arabic. Let's see how you do with Hebrew, and we'll translate. Repeat after me. Let's see, what shall we do today? Fahine. Matov.
Matov.
Ooh.
Manayim.
Shevet.
Achim.
Gam.
Yachad.
Now, for those of you that know Arabic, half of the words you already knew because Hebrew and Arabic share the same roots. So, just to translate, Hine, behold how beautiful it is for brothers and sisters to sit together in unity. Psalm 133. It's perfect. For today. Perfect for today. So I come to you right on the eve of the Jewish holy day of Passover, and I use the experiences of Passover to help instruct me about how important today is. Because in Passover, first described in the book of Exodus, the Pharaoh who enslaved our people for over 400 years said we could not have our own calendar. We could not have our own way of telling time. The only way of telling time was the slave owner's time, was Pharaoh's time. And then Moses, Musa, blessings be unto him, he said, enough with this. God said the Jewish people, the Israelites, must tell their own time and their own way. And we established our own calendar. And it's only when we established our own calendar that we became a people. Fast forward, we come to our Christian brothers and sisters. The Sabbath was always celebrated on the Saturday. But the early church leaders said if they're going to become a new people, they need to have their own Sabbath, and they moved the Sabbath day to Sunday. And they did that, and they controlled their own holidays, and the Christian people became a people. Enter the Muslims. Beautiful holidays, Eid, a beautiful way of celebrating feast days, and Eid al-Fitr better than all the rest, the end of Ramadan. The holidays, the symbol of Ramadan, I don't need to tell you, you can tell me, community, am I correct? introspection. Am I correct?
Yes.
Sadaqah, charity. Am I correct?
Yes.
Are these things that are American? They're American. The Muslim is together. In fact, this year, if I'm not mistaken, Al-Fatah will come on the 4th of July, taking the American culture and taking the Muslim culture and making this bridge of understanding that can only be the hand of Allah, the hand of God. Am I right? Of course I'm right. This is a day that God made. Hodu l'Adonai ki tov. Give praise to God, for God's glory exists forever. This is our special gift to come together. And as we learn about the values of Islam through their holidays, that's how we'll create our bridge of understanding. That's how we'll break down our walls. The holy days is our introspection into the true life of the religion. So this is a gift not only to the Muslim community, it's a gift to the bigger community. I'm part of a community that fought to try to get Rosh Hashanah, the Jewish New Year, Yom Kippur, the Day of Atonement, onto the school calendar as well, because we have to be in synagogue all day. And to say that it's a break day, a vacation day, I'm sorry, my rabbi, I'm leading services. It's no picnic, I'll tell you. It's a day of really working hard to come close to God. It's not a day of waving flags. It's a day of going out and protesting and trying to find our soul and trying to come close to God. This is the work of Muslims during the days of Ramadan. And finally, when you come to that, you can thank God I came close. And now you want to celebrate it with us and actually shukran. From the center of my heart, I will be with you on this day. I will be you on every day. God bless you.
Thank you very much, Rabbi Gilles. Our next speaker is Imam Umar Hassan al-Haj. He is one of the most distinguished members of the Muslim community in Delaware. He's been here for several decades. He's an imam, at least one of the imams at the Masjid al-Kawthar in Wilmington. And I had lots of wonderful experiences. He's spoken in my class, and we have also spoken together at many public events. He is a wonderful brother. I truly love him.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله والصلاة والسلام وعلى رسول الله النبي السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Me and that brother back there, Muhammad Salam, are overjoyed from our community because our day leader, Sheikh Imam W.D. Muhammad, said this is the day of religion. And he meant by this is the day of religion that when Christians, Muslims, and Jews and all sit down at the same table and come up with some moral, concrete moral fiber information that we can unite the whole of humanity. You know, the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a messenger to all mankind. And it is our duty as believers in God, not just Muslims, because the book says he named us Muslim before the advent of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So I got some Muslim Christian friends, I got some Muslim Jewish friends, etc. Because I'm trying to follow, and we should be trying to follow the traditions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So I'm very thankful, Tom. This actually for us is a gift from God, then from Tom.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
This is a gift from the creator of the heavens and earth, yes, that we are growing in numbers, because at one time when you said Muslims in this country, you talked about the indigenous African American Muslim community. But now we can say the indigenous Muslim community consists of European Americans, Native Americans, Latino Americans, and our immigrant population from into this culture. So again, this is a mercy and a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then from Tom and his dad.
Thank you. Thank you, Imam Umar. Our next speaker is Brother Hamar Ahmed. Hamar Ahmed is the president of the Islamic Society of Delaware. The Islamic Society of Delaware runs, maintains, and operates the biggest mosque in the area, Masjid Ibrahim, and they also have wonderful events like an open house that we just had 2 days ago.
Thank you. Good evening.
Good evening.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace be upon all of you. It is a very important occasion. Not just important for Muslims in general, but particularly for our children, because it is going to give them the feeling of enjoying the American value of being treated equally and fairly. Because so far, with these important days not being recognized, our children, the Muslim children, had to go to school, do the homework, or if they are going to take off, of course, you know, they will have to use a sick day, or if not, I'm sorry, not a sick day, some sort of a day which they will have to cover.
Excuse
day. So, thank you very much. Excuse day. So, with this proclamation signed, it is going to give them a feeling that they are being treated equally, which is the demand of the American value and the American right. So this is a very important occasion to realize that. I do appreciate all of the efforts which are done by Professor Muqtada Khan, Brother Jameel, Brother Naveed, and many of the other members of the Muslim community who have contributed to bring this to a future, I mean, to a realization. But especially I would like to thank Executive Gordon, because this is his vision, that he proactively reached out to the Muslim community like any other segment of the community. And since that time, he has been working hard to continue strengthening the relationship between the county government and the Muslim community in this county. Based on the debate, the political debate which is going on right now, as many of the respected speakers before me has mentioned and identified, that it is very important that there should be a continuous dialogue between people of all faiths so that we can understand each other's faith and we can actually understand each other to live harmoniously together. And in accordance with that demand, or in order to meet the demand, of course, you know, like any other Islamic organizations or masajids, the Islamic Society of Delaware is also doing many programs, which was also mentioned by Professor Muqtada Khan, that we had an open house this last weekend. There was one session which was done on Friday evening, and there were two sessions which were done on Saturdays. And I would like to again thank Executive Gordon that he had a very busy day on Saturday, but he made it a point that he wants to attend that open house, and we were pleased to see him attending that morning session on Saturday. While I'm talking about Executive Gordon, let me must mention that he has a wonderful team. The entire team under his vision is working very hard to foster and strengthen these relationships. I would like to thank Deputy CEO Sam, as well as Angela, who has always been working hard to meet our demands for scheduling the events. I'm sorry that, you know, I don't want to take too much time, but I still wanted to recognize that all of these people who Tom has in his team, they have been working hard to make sure that this vision of strengthening and continuously strengthening the relationship between the county government and the Muslim community of this this county is becoming more and more of a reality and is stronger. At this point, I would of course like to thank the Councilman Panel Solis for coming here and joining us. And definitely it's a great pleasure to see Reverend you joining us at important location. And you have always been there whenever we have needed you to help and support us. And that is the way to go. And we will continue trying to do our part. And we are looking forward to have a very strong relationship with people of all faith. And with the help of everyone, we are looking forward to have a very harmonious life together here, irrespective of what kind of political debates around us. we can defeat all of them, and we are sure that we can do that with the help of a strong leader like Executive Gordon. So with that, thank you very much for listening to me. I appreciate it. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi.
I have a difficult task of closing this out, but I wanted to share just one thought with you, and I want to talk to you a little bit about what we call as identity. Our identities have many, many parts of it. We are Americans, we are Muslims, we are all, some of us are from different parts of the world, some of us are first-generation Americans, some are immigrants, etc. But what is common to all of us is that we have an external and one, an internal aspect of our identity. So all people, all human beings, regardless of their faith, their religion, their race, want to celebrate their externality in the sense of community, and what is internal to them is they want to develop in their privacy. So when you are not embraced by the community that you belong to, when you are not recognized by others, then your externality is suffocated. So your growth is retarded. It is, you may or may not grow inside, but your outside doesn't grow. So it is very important for all communities in every society. It's not just in America, but I hope that the example of America leads Muslim countries to recognize their minorities, to allow them the same freedom that America allows Muslim minorities to celebrate, to recognize their festivals. So I think this is, in that sense, this is, even though it's such a small county, in such a small state, in such a corner of the United States of America, I hope that this event becomes a beacon for diversity, for pluralism, for tolerance. I want to clearly, once again, reiterate that Tom Garden has been a great friend of the community. We will always remember that. He will be remembered when we write the history. One of these young fellows is hopefully going to write the history of Muslims of Delaware, and one chapter will definitely be devoted to Tom Garden. I also want to specially thank some guy who worked with us. This process is not something that just happened overnight. We've been talking about this, discussing this for months. In fact, I don't know how many iterations of the proclamation that Sam and I and Luigi just kept going back and forth and back and forth. So during this entire discussion period, there are hours and hours of meetings. What was remarkable was that Tom was able to find hours to sit with us to discuss the logistics and parts of this. Sam has not just been a friend who's worked with us, but he's been like our guru. I don't know whether you understand the word guru. Guru is like a mentor. So he has mentored us. Not only did he help us and he just took us through the process, but he also taught us a lot of things while doing that about how to be effective social activists in this country, and particularly in this state whose politics are very unusual. So I especially also want to thank Sam Guy. I want to thank all our friends, the interfaith friends, Reverend Greg Jones, Michael Beals, and others who are here. I want to especially thank Muslims. I want to recognize some of the Muslims, colleagues, and friends. First and foremost, I want to recognize all these kids. Raise your hand and give yourself a hand. You are the future of Muslims. And most probably, when you grow up, you might take a lot of things for granted, but just go back and remember that this may seem something so trivial to you, but it was so important to us when we got this recognition. I also want to recognize the teachers who are bringing them up. I want to especially recognize Dr. Salim Khan, who oftentimes people are confused when they say Dr. Khan. He is being a mentor of this community. He is what we call a Muslim. He is a representation of our history, our tradition, and culture, and these kids are our future. I also want to recognize Imam Salam, Ahmad Salam, who is here. I learned from him that he had started this process in the 1960s. I hope you give me the copies of the documents that he has had, and we will move forward with it. I also want to recognize Dr. Muhammad Abdullah, who is also here, who is also an important member of the community. I want to recognize Brother Hassan Majid, who is here, Brother Shahid Badra. I also want to recognize Tariq Masood. There's one person I especially want to recognize here is my mother. My mother is coming here. She's sitting there and she's recovering from the surgery. I also want to thank Dr. Amna Latif for bringing her entire school here for this event and supporting her in many, many of other projects of Delaware Council. The Delaware Council's goal is to mainstream Muslims in Delaware. Our goal is to increase and build bridges with mainstream communities to bring interfaith, to bring Muslims to the table where policies are made so that we can. This is one step which is encouraging us to say that when we put our efforts into it, we see results. And I'm very, very glad that I have two extremely wonderful friends. You know, imagine Delaware Council as a jet plane that is flying on two engines. One is Jamil, enthusiasm, and one is Naveed, who is hard work. I sit in the cabin, sipping the soda. So, I want to thank everybody again for coming. This was a great day. And alhamdulillah, with the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have all been witnesses to this. Thank you very much.
Yeah.